in the name that is above every other name. Resolve that cancels fear. Resolve that cancels insult. Begin to happen in your life in the name of Jesus. I have the word of God for somebody here. Maybe something is beginning to happen in your life. God said, I should tell you, you've not seen anything. I said, you've not seen anything. I said, you have not started. Let me quickly share a testimony with you. Last month, there is barely a day that somebody will not bless me. And at the time, I was afraid. My wife was afraid. Ah, what's happening? She said, it's time. I said, no, it's not time. It's about to be time. You know, when you are cooking a good soup, in those days, our mothers will call us. They will not take the soup home. Just the spoon from the soup. I decree for somebody here, whatever you are enjoying now is not the main course. It's not the main meal. It's just a towel for you. I decree the main meal is coming soon. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you this morning. I wanted to say after me, say, Father, this morning, my spirit is alive. Come on, say it loud. My mind is alert. I receive the engrafted word of God. And I decree and I declare that your word will bless me. Your word will profit me. Your word will prosper me. I take actions on the word that I will hear today. I am disciplined to do the word in the name of Jesus. And at the end of today, I am richly blessed. I am healed. I receive breakthrough in Jesus' name. Come on, just greet your neighbor and say, welcome to church. Hallelujah. Praise God. Come on, if you're excited to be in church this morning, welcome to church. We want to celebrate all our online viewers, all those who are worshiping with us online. We want to celebrate you. We love you. Thank you so much for joining us again. Thank you for welcoming us into your homes, your cars, your office. And we want to say we celebrate you and we love you dearly. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'm so excited to be here this morning. And I know everybody here, we are all excited to be here. We are all looking beautiful. Hallelujah. So there's no much word this morning. This Sunday is our success or what we call Career Sunday. And by the grace of God, I'll just give a brief word for maybe 5-10 minutes. Then we'll do some discussions. I know there are some of us here who are doing one or two things. I'll just call you randomly to ask you questions. And so get ready, because I'm going to call you. Hallelujah. Yeah, so get ready, get set. I'm going to call you just to share some things with us. Hallelujah. So we're talking about what's your hustle. Ask your neighbor, what's your hustle? Come on, don't be afraid to ask them. Tell them, what's your hustle? All right. Make sure they are looking at you and you are looking at them when you are asking them. Ask them, what's your hustle? Hallelujah. You see, let me start by saying that whether you succeed or fail in life, it's your fault. Tell your neighbor, whether you succeed or fail, it's all your fault. So what I'm saying in regards to that is that your success or your failure is your responsibility. So it means that you can't blame the government. You can't blame your parents. You can't blame your uncle. You can't blame your friends for not giving you a loan. You can't blame anybody. It's all your responsibility. And I'm saying that because for some of us here, we are students. And we hope that after 4 years or 3 years, we go out and serve. And after serving, you hope to look for a job. I'm sorry to disappoint you that you may not find that job. Because almost about 1 million students graduate from Nigerian University every year. And we have less than 50,000 every year. We have less than 50,000 jobs being provided every year by the government. And that's why it's important that you know that you have to have an hustle. You have to, you know, when we talk about hustling, there's this mindset or picture that comes to our mind that, oh, you're just doing anything and just doing everything. No, that's not hustling. That's not what we're talking about. So the first thing I need you to know is that you have to have a hustle. You have to have a hustle. You have to have something you are doing. And before you can even say you want to have any hustle, the first thing you must have is a dream. The word of success is for dreamers. It's for dreamers. So you must have a dream that drives you. You know, at times, it's not about what you drive. It's about what drives you. It is what drives you today that will determine what you will drive tomorrow. It is what drives you today that will determine what you drive tomorrow. It is not about what you live in now. It's about what lives in you now. It's not about what you live in now. It's about what lives in you now. So you don't know, I'm living in one bedroom apartment now. That's fine. That doesn't matter. What matters is that is there a mansion living in you now? Oh, four of us are squatting, living in a room. That doesn't matter. What matters is that you see 10 mansions living in you. It's not about what you wear now that matters. It's about what is wearing you, what is covering you, what is coming on you. So we are not so concerned about, I'm not wearing Gucci. I'm not wearing Louis Vuitton. I'm not wearing even those brands. Versace. I'm not wearing all those things. But are you wearing passion? Are you wearing dreams? Are you wearing discipline? Because that's what will determine what you will wear tomorrow. Hallelujah. So you need to have a dream. What's your dream? Your dream creates your drive. Your dream creates your drive. A man without dream is a man without drive. A man without purpose is a man without passion. It is your dream that creates your drive. When you see a man that wakes up in the morning doing something, it's because there is a dream. But when you see a man that wakes up in the morning and goes back to bed, that man has no dream. And because he has no dream, he has no drive. So you don't ask people, why is it that you don't have drive? No, you ask them, why is it that you don't have a dream? Hallelujah. So you need to know that you must not be ashamed of your hustle. Tell your neighbor, don't be ashamed. I'll tell you what I've had to do. There was a time in my life I was pushing over like just to get extra. So you need to know that at times you don't do what you love. At times you need to do what you need to do what you love to do. Somebody to write that down. At times you need to do what you need to do for you to do what you love to do. I know at times you say, do what you love. There are times that you must do what you need to do so that you can do what you love to do. Because there are times that what you love to do is not right, is not paying now, and you need to go to school. You need to pay some bills. You need to start what you love to do as a business. So you need a leverage to climb up. Who loves to do Okada? There was a time in my life that me and my dad, how many of you know Ikwekutele? Those that you say, Ikwekutele, you know, Ikwekutele, you know, we used to hawk in markets, like markets, rat killer. That's what we said. That was what we need to do to, for me to go to school. So you don't need to be ashamed of what you do. If all you need to do now is to wash clothes for people, because it's dry cleaners, good name, is to wash clothes for people, for you to be able to leverage to go to the next level you have to do. If you need to take a 10,000 naira job to have savings of 50,000 naira that you need to start your cake business, why are you ashamed to do that? So you need to know that. Don't be ashamed. Oh, maybe you work with the people that used to pack tents around. Don't be ashamed of it. You know that when my dad used to take me along to go and sell these grass killers, at times I would be ashamed because I would see my classmates. And I would go and hide. I would just go to sell something. I was ashamed. But he was not ashamed. Hallelujah. Tell somebody, don't be ashamed of your hustle. If you are selling clothes, don't be ashamed of it. If you're selling shoes, don't be ashamed of it. The other people we have today, they all started from somewhere. Some of them, it was in doing what they were, that little thing they were doing that brought the opportunity for the great thing they are doing now. So whatever you want to do, you need to know that you need to start somewhere. Tell your neighbor, start somewhere. You need to start somewhere.
When my wife came back from the US, and she had invested some money to something that she had went somewhere like that, in a field, and it was a struggle. And she had to take up a job of 10,000 naira a month. 10,000 naira, that's probably what you spend in a day. But that was what she needed to do to get us to work where we need to be. It was in that place that other opportunities. That's what the Bible says, whatever. It is specified, say, whatever your hands find to do, he said, do it. I know we talk about purpose, that you must work in your purpose. There are times you need to do something entirely different from your purpose to be able to work in your purpose. That's the reality of life. There are times you need to get lost before you get found. Hallelujah. So, another thing that you need to start small and grow big. Tell somebody that start small. The only reason why some people are still not starting anything is because they want to be big. They want to start big. If you start big, you'll fall below the big. And every multiple $1 billion company I know today started either from the garage or from their house or from their room or from their hostel, started somewhere. So you need to start small and grow from being small. Don't let big intimidate your small. You want to start a clothesline and you are looking like, when will they eat this? People buy my nose. Don't let other people's great intimidate your small. It's good to start small. There's nothing wrong with that. Start local, think global. whatever also you are involved in, start from your area, from your friends, from your family. But when you are doing that, think of the world. Think of the world. Whatever you are doing at all, always think of global relevance.
Hallelujah.
Let me talk about one or two things that you can remove.
Hallelujah. Next.
Now, also, one of the things you need to know is that you must know how to master your failures and pain. In your bid to succeed, don't try to escape from failure. Don't try to. Failure is part of success. In fact, what gives success value is failure. What makes people to listen to your story is because of how many times you have failed. There are times you have failed 100 times, but when you succeed for one time, that success will cover for all your times of failure. Praise the Lord. Also, you must know when to give up. Hallelujah. You must know when to give up. You know, at times we talk about determination. I say, be determined. Don't give up. Don't this. Don't that. But you see, there are times you need to give up. There are times you are going on the wrong direction, and you need to give up on that wrong direction for you to be able to go to the right direction. Determination is great. But no, you have to discern when you have to give up on something. Maybe it's not working. Continue. It's good. But there are times you need to change. There are times you need to diversify. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It's my prayer that your hustle will soon become your story. A story that the world will tell. So you are here this morning. Don't be discouraged. I'm not even talking to people who are students here. If you are a student, not secondary school, primary school student, please make sure you start doing something. Start selling something. You know what? Why I appreciate education. Education will not be, so the kind of education we have now, today, will not bring food on your table. And you need to leverage on your learning opportunities. Because this is the time for you to learn how to sell, how to relate, how to network, how to create, how to innovate. Because at the end of the day, if anybody is going to employ you, what they are going to ask is your skill. What can you do? Not what you read. What you read is good, but what you can do is better. So you need to start taking up skills, even while in school. Why in school? Why study? Start learning something. Start getting a side also. Learn video editing. Learn coding. Learn web development. Learn tailoring. Learn makeup. Learn online marketing. These are things that will transform your life. And that's not more boys today, ladies today. People who have a degree yet, they are doing very fine. So don't let your degree become a stumbling block for your growth. Hallelujah. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So let me ask again once more.
Actually, no, what's wrong? Alright, so we want to go into discussion now. The major thing I want to discuss for about 20 minutes, I'll call different people out and we'll talk. Number one thing I want to discuss, I want us to talk about is what's your greatest challenge or challenges in making out? I'm talking about your goal.
I'm talking about legit.
What's your greatest challenge? What you do right now? What's your, maybe you are not even doing anything now, but what's stopping you from doing something?